wherever he is. Faithful. How many can attest to his faithfulness even this week? Hallelujah. My heart is full of gratitude for the faithfulness of the Lord. Prepare the way. Make straight the path for him. Let the King of glory enter in. Let the King of glory enter in. Who is this King? attest to his faithfulness even this week. Hallelujah. My heart is full of gratitude for the faithfulness of the Lord.
Prepare the way. Make straight the path for him. The King of glory enter in. Let the King of glory enter in. Who is this King?
Right. I hope that you all are ready for the catching away. So we are just a few days away, a few hours away and a lot of people is falling away. Hello to all my brothers and sisters in here. Alright, so spread this light. Oh yes, I have a lot to tell you all today. I have a lot to teach you all today as well. Alright, to all my brothers and sisters. True brothers and sisters, eh? True brothers and sisters in Yaya. Those that who truly love the Triune Eternal Family. Alright, so as we can see right about now, a fireball. Yes, a fireball over Russia. So a lot of people would not take this as a serious warning, but this is very, very serious, right? To you, it might be a normal fireball, but no, that is a sign of the end times. And as we cross into the month of August 2019, we're going to see more than one fireball. Right, so people are going to be recording like thousands of fireball raining from the atmosphere. That is going to happen soon. You see how much plagues And you see what plagues and things happening all over the world, right? You see what plagues happening in Las Vegas. You see plagues happening. You see plagues happening in America, Saudi Arabia, France with worms, different plagues. All right. So when we enter into the month of August, we're going to see an increase of those bright fireballs, right? Not meteor, right? There's nothing called meteor, right? As a fireball sent from the hands of the Creator, right? So the signs of the plagues is an indication that we are in the end. Yes, the blood red river, the blood red water happening in Jamaica, happening in Trinidad, happening in Venezuela, different anomalies, things that never happened before is now occurring all over the earth. Yes, there's a serious drought as well going on right about now all over the earth right now, as Europe is still going through a serious heat wave, and that heat wave will be distributed to places like China and all those different places will begin to experience the heat waves. But as of right now, Elohim is dealing with splitting the earth in half, right? So all this our soul, earthquakes, bigger earthquakes will begin to happen. Let me draw closer. Bigger earthquakes will begin to happen in the Philippines. After the Philippines, it will cross over to Africa, Somalia, all them different places, Nigeria, Kenya, all those different places will experience an uptick or in earthquakes. When we cross into the month of August, you are going to see all these things that I prophesy right now. When we cross into the month of August, we are going to see more plagues in more places, as that will be an indication and a sign of the end. All right, so you all are ready. All right, I also want to talk about the mud volcano that erupted in Trinidad. I also want to talk about the volcano that happened in, let's get this a little bit. I also want to talk about the Right. I also want to talk about the mud volcano that erupted in Trinidad a few days ago. Well, it's the day they discovered it, but you know, Archangel Samuel already told you all where all these mud volcanoes will be. All these mud volcanoes will be erupting. So yes, I deserve credit because I tell you all things before it ever happened. Right? Yeah, we're gonna talk about the mud volcanoes. We're also gonna be talking about I can't remember the name of the volcano right now, or the name of the mountain, but what I'm going to do here, I'm just going to slip in, all right, and I'm going to bring up the mountain, and people in Indonesia who know where this mountain is, I can't remember the name of the mountain right now, but this mountain right now is erupting right now in Indonesia. And they don't know because no one hasn't been up there. As I told you all already, that is in Lombok, and that is our new fire volcano. Let me see if I can bring up the video. All right, I'm gonna bring up the video there for a split second. All right, so those in Indonesia, could you pinpoint where this volcano is in Indonesia? Right, this volcano, this is a new improved fire volcano. It's in Lombok. All right, for some people who are in Indonesia right now, where is this volcano? I can't remember the name right now of the volcano, but this volcano is in Lombok, Indonesia. And this volcano will help us in dealing with bringing destruction in Lombok, as there are sinkholes already open in Lombok. So this volcano is right now being filled with lava, right? This lava will be distributed through all the major sinkholes that will be opening that will be opening in Lombok in Indonesia. All right, this is a new volcano, right? For anybody on the live, all right, I have warned the people in Indonesia that there will be a new fire volcano. This is a new fire volcano, right? This is a new improved fire volcano that Yahuwah has created in on the island in Lombok. I can't remember the name of it right now. Wati, somebody. this volcano just shown signs a few weeks ago when Yahuwah put a covering over the mouth of the volcano. Now, mind you, people, mind you, the seismologists or volcanologists in Lombok in Indonesia, BMKG, they don't even know that this is a volcano, right? They don't know. And as we speak right now in this hour, that volcano is right now erupting, right? And BMKG is telling the people, BMKG does like UV seismic. They don't know one set, right? BMKG in Lombok, right? They are the ones responsible for giving all the earthquake reports and blah, blah, blah. All right? That's in Lombok. Lombok is in Indonesia. Note, last year, Lombok had a really major, a mega earthquake right now. Lombok had a mega earthquake last year. But this year, things will be different, as I told you all already. Things will be different as we are going to end the world. All right? So because the world is going to end, there's no need to do another earthquake to kill you all so fast. You all need to see the error of your ways. All right? Once you see the error of your ways, you'll be able to understand why destruction or judgment or why your death will be sudden. All right? So that's the reason why everybody on earth has been given an opportunity to repent and to return unto the triune eternal family. This has been a joke, all right? Now, this volcano is right now showing signs of eruption in Indonesia. Also, a few days ago, on the 27th, we had another volcano in the west of Java, Indonesia, that erupted, right? Let me bring up that video for you all, right? Let me see if I could, can't bring up both back-to-back video, but this volcano, right, called Rajuni, I think it's Rajuni is the name of it. This volcano is right now erupting right now. So you're BMKG telling them, Emperor Frank. BMKG in Indonesia. And what are telling them? They're telling them there's fire, right? They're telling them there's fire happening on the mountain there. No, that's a new fire volcano. A new fire volcano, our new and improved fire volcano. That's like how Guatemala have a fire volcano, right? That's like how France have a fire volcano. That's like how Yellowstone is a super volcano. Well, this volcano in Indonesia, Lombok, is not a super volcano, but could be a super volcano. Depends on the eruption stages, right? So right now, we're going through the falling the lava into the volcano. Well, they don't call it a volcano, right? They call it a mountain, right? They just call it a mountain in Indonesia. But, I mean, anytime you see a cloud covering the top of a mountain, that is a volcano there. The beginning of a new volcano, right? Yes. Yes, sister. Amber, yes, definitely. There are new volcanoes too developing right now in Trinidad. Yes. And as I said already in my life of yesterday, Yahuwah, El Elyon, the Almighty, the Father of creation, the Almighty Creator. Yahuwah said that he's going to take lava, right, from other volcanoes. As you all could see just a while ago, see, I can just bring that up for you all. Just a while ago, we saw an earthquake happen in the southern Atlantic Ridge, right? Those earthquakes are happening in the southern Atlantic Ridge. Let me see if I can just bring it up there quickly for you all. These earthquakes, This earthquake, right, that happened in the southern Atlantic Ridge. This earthquake supplies, let me see if I can just bring up the full map for you there, boy. All right. Oh, let me just give my excuse there. Right. No, not this one. Let me see if I can bring up the full map for you there, boy. Yeah. I bring up the full map. Let's see if that works. Right. Now, as I said already, the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, right? This is where the earthquake happened, right? This happened about an hour ago. Now, this earthquake that happened there is to take lava from here. So it's from point, say from lava from, see if I could just scroll it across there really quick to show you all. All right, so the lava, if you look closely, all right, this is the northern, the southern Mid-Atlantic Ridge, right? So we're going to scroll down, that I can't zoom out to show you all what I'm talking about, or that I could show you all. Look what Trinidad and Tobago is, right? This is the northern Atlantic Ridge, right? This is the northern Atlantic Ridge. Let me see when this happened. Let me see if it will show up. Right, 6 days ago, this is the central Atlantic Ridge. Watch carefully how ABBA taking the lava from Argentina and all those other places to bring it to Trinidad. Look carefully. Every time an earthquake happens, all right, this down here will be Bolivia, Argentina. ABBA taking lava. He's taking lava from the volcano in Chile, not Mexico. Mexico higher up, right? ABBA is taking lava from the Chile volcano. Taking it right now, yeah. Let me look good. And he send it now to the southern Atlantic Ridge, right? From the southern Atlantic Ridge, let's go up. From the southern Atlantic Ridge, now he carried the lava from the southern down here and he put it up here, right? So, where's that one, boy? All right, so you all see the mouse, right? So Yahuwah take the lava from the southern and he put it in the central. And from the central, he put it in the northern. And from the northern, he going to transport that lava to Trinidad and Tobago. Now, if you watch carefully how the earthquakes happen, the pattern of the earthquake, it specifically states definitely that Yahuwah is taking lava from Chile volcano, transporting it straight up the southern, central, and northern Atlantic Ridge. And he is going to pull it to Trinidad. Let me see if I can just bring it up there. Where the ass is this, buddy? Right. So we see a lot of earthquakes happening there, right? Watch carefully. If you watch carefully from the this is the central, just to make it clear, it is the central. This is the central. This is the northern Atlantic Ridge. 6 days ago, right? 6 days ago, and boom, all right, and boom. Just now, a while ago, an hour ago, he come in the southern Mid-Atlantic Ridge. So he takes lava from the southern, transported to the transported to the central, and from the central he carried to the northern. Now, before he transported the lava from the southern to the northern, he had to create a path for the lava to flow. So the pattern of the earthquake states that our Father Yahuwah is transporting lava from point A to point B, right? Yahuwah take the lava from down there and he is going to put it into Trinidad. So that is going to happen. That is going to Trinidad, right? So Trinidad, right? Trinidad, all right? Trinidad and Tobago. Currently, let me see if I can zoom in, boy. All right. Let's see, I could just zoom into Trinidad. And I'll show you all exactly where, oh boy. And I'll show you exactly where the, right. I want to show you all where the volcano erupted today, right? I want to show you all where the volcano erupted today. Let me see if I could just bring that back up there. Right, so that you all have a understanding, all right? You all will have an understanding of how Yahuwah is doing certain things.
Forever he is faithful. How many can attest to his faithfulness even this week? Hallelujah. My heart is full of gratitude for the faithfulness of the Lord. Prepare the way. Make straight the path for him. Let the King of glory enter in. Let the King of glory enter in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty to save. The earth is full of his glory.
We come back. We are back. We are back. We are back. That is where the volcano in Trinidad erupted, not far from Piparo. All right. So what I'm going to do is bring up a map. All right. I'm going to bring up a map again. And I keep showing Trinidadians and other people around the earth proof of everything that I'm saying, that it will come to pass. But when it comes to pass, when you expect it to come to pass. The mud volcano will play a part in the destruction of Trinidad, right? So remember I told you all already that the southern part of Trinidad will be destroyed by the earthquake that is going to happen in Maturin. Yes, but certain part of Trinidad must sink, all right? That is the reason why the world needs to listen to me. Everybody should be listening to me. Everybody should be listening to me because everything I have spoken, me a bluffing, and me a boasting. Everything that I have spoken has definitely come to pass with proof. So people should open their eyes for real. You know, people should be really opening their eyes for real and seeing, right? Archangel Samuel spoke about the mud volcano, fire volcano, also kicked them Jenny and kicked them Jack. I spoke about that. Right now, you notice that kick them Jenny and kick them Jack. right? That the Grenada observation, people who responsible for the Kick Them journey, is not releasing. Listen me carefully. There have been a lot of activity. Yes, there's a lot of activity happening right now in Kick Them journey in Grenada, and they are not alerting the public at all because they don't want to bring a scare bullshit, right? So there's a lot of scare tactics out there, a lot of false people talking about this and talking about that. But to be honest with the public, don't listen to these people. I am the one you should be listening to, right? Because I am the one to lead you into the New Jerusalem. I am the one to lead you into Zion. I am the only one that truly comes forth and lay the cards on the table and tell you the truth, right? Your government, UV seismic, BMKG, all the other seismologists will not tell you exactly anything at all. Remain on the live. Don't run away from the live. We have a lot. We have a lot still revealed to you, right? I want the Trinidadian people to. I wonder if you all remember. I'm gonna make a little run away from the live. I want to teach you all something. I want to show you all another proof, right? How serious it is to listen to what I'm saying, right? I want you to understand how serious this really is. It might sound like a fairy tale to some people, but I want people to listen. Don't run away from the life. Right, I find this picture. I wanna coincide something here, and I want people to understand. Our next earthquake boy. All right. So, don't run away from the life. Central East Pacific rise. Wow. Is he not doing things quickly? Yes. This is the life that you need to be on right about now, folks. This is the life you need to be on right now, as the rapture or the catching away is about to happen. I ain't bluffing and I ain't lying to the public. I'm telling the public the truth. The rapture, the catching away, is about to happen. We are just a few days away from the rapture happening. I am the only one on the earth that truly telling you the truth. Accurately, I am the one that telling you upfront things before it ever happened, right? Right. 7 minutes ago. Right. Okay, 7 minutes ago. 4.5. Right. That is the Central East Pacific rise. I'll show you all where that is just now, and I will explain to the public what's really going on. If I have 100 people on this live, I will tell people exactly where this volcano is connecting to, right? I want 100 people on the live. 100. Come on. We can make 100 people. Let me make 100 people. Let us kick off this live viral, all right? And let people know definitely what's going to happen or what's happening and why the relevant authority is not telling the public of all these beautiful things that are happening, because they have no idea what's going to happen. Please, before you send a friend request to me, please let me know privately the purpose of why you want to connect. Because some people are connecting, but they're serious, right? So I'm only looking for serious people who really ready, who really, really ready to enter into the New Jerusalem. Right, so what I'm gonna do now, I am going to put the let me just bring this up there. So I bring this up clearly for the public. Now we see a red river, and now we see a mud volcano eruption. Right, let me just breathe a little bit. Just relax a little bit and ask yourself this question. Why the river red and why the mud volcano erupt? Not too long, there was a red river seen in Trinidad, not too far from Paparo. Yes, not too, it wasn't. Let me tell you something. Where the red river was discovered, it's not far from Paparo. No. So let's just relax now, right? Relax, stay on the live, invite your brother, invite your sister, everybody else, right?
Forever he is faithful. How many can attest to his faithfulness even this week? Hallelujah. My heart is full of gratitude for the faithfulness of the Lord.
Prepare the way. Make straight the path for him. Let the King of glory enter in. Let the King of glory enter in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty to save. The earth is full of His glory. Creation, prepare the way. His love endureth forever. His
song. Hallelujah.
Prepare. Yeah, what are we going to do, eh? I am going to play the actual audio, right, of this video that was done today. I'm just going to go back from the starting, right? And I'm going to play the actual audio of this video.
Open on both sides now, and you're trying to figure out if there's a trap. That's it, sir.
Okay. 15 minutes walk. That's all.
So, we're here with Suresh Raparan, who is one of the people who discovered the mud volcano, and he's going to take us into the forest now. And Suresh, how long it's going to take us to get there?
10 to 15 minutes walk from structure.
Structure.
There. This is what we found here, a volcano. All that day is more. What for 2 months you can put here? Okay. There it is.
So
we call
it
for
Longley Street, or
the cell as a result of it?
Why would they do this for Longley Street?
For Longley Street? I tell you, don't drive. That's too much.
Snap off the trees.
So, the villagers were right. At Colonzo Road in Brickfield Village off the Tabakit Main Road, this mud volcano actually erupted several weeks ago.
Open on both sides now, and you're trying to figure out if there's a trap. That's it, sir.
Okay.
Okay. 15 minutes walk. That's all.
So we're here with Suresh Ruparan, who is one of the people who discovered the mud volcano, and he's gonna take us into the forest now. And Suresh, how long it's gonna take us to get there?
10 to 15 minutes walk from Strakia.
Strakia. Yeah. Okay.
All right. So this is what I'm gonna do now. Right? Well, you all know the location already of this mud volcano. It's not a biggie. It's not a biggie to the public, right? Because it's quite in the jungle, right? It didn't erupt where it had civilization where people live in. But let me tell you something. You all have no idea what is Yahuwah plan. No idea whatsoever, right? Devika do not know Abba's plan. Ragu, none of them. None of them psychics in Trinidad knows. None of them pastors. None of them deacons. None of them. Right? None of them see a man or Obia man knows what is Yahuwah plan. Right? But I know what is Yahuwah plan. Because I reveal it to the public just as he gave me it. Right? But as a madman, because I told you all about a mud volcano that will erupt not far from the power of volcano. And I also told you all that I just told you all already that rivers will be turned blood and all this kind of thing. May I remind you, Trinidadians, right? In 2017, let me bring up a video. Let me see. I wonder if I can find that video, boy. I can't remember if I have that video, you know. But I wonder if I have that video still, boy. That video is about, let's see if I have that video. That video is with Red. I wonder if I could find that video, boy. Not sure if I still have that video here in my catalog. But in 2017, there was a river in Diego Martin turning blood red. And you know where stupid UV seismic and them say? Yeah, nice paint the Trinity River, right? So every time something catastrophic going on happen in Trinidad, and you see the warnings before it ever happened, UV seismic and all the other seismologists always talking some kind of fuckery or some kind of shit about nice red paint, somebody throw paint in the water. You tell me, use a big freaking seismologist or whatever they call yourself. Right, you watching a big freaking pool, right? Running a red water, running right down the stream, and you talking about somebody throw paint in the river. That is how stupid people believe in these stupid. How you could be in your right sense as a human being, right? And the Red River, right, is nowhere close to a paint factory, is nowhere close to civilization, right? But this Red River wasn't far from the volcano that erupted there, right? So, UV seismic and all the other psychologists who did tests come back and tell the dotish public that was paint. Or you can be in the right sense, see a big river of blood. Yeah, a big river of blood. Right, a big river of blood, and talking about I paint. They said I red paint, folks. This is how stupid people buying these rubbish from UV seismic and them, right? Because they don't want to come out and tell the public the actual truth. That is a plague, right? That is blood red. That is a plague. The creator turned that river blood red. And the creator, Yahuwah, know that somebody would have discovered it. And let me tell you something, eh? Yahuwah, lead that person, right, who was looking for, I can't remember what he said he was looking for, but that person said he was looking for volcanoes or mangoes. I think he was looking for mangoes or hunting or something like that. And he stumbled upon a river, blood red. That is a plague, Trinidadians, right? That is a plague, right? That is not a river full of paint, right? Oh, anybody in the right mind will watch a blood river, right? A blood river, and say that is a died somebody throw red paint. You see red paint? Oh God, somebody throw red paint inside of the water. So everybody believe that shit. Everybody believe that somebody come and throw red paint in the river. They're not telling the public the truth. All right. So let the deception continue to that audience. Give yourself a clap for being daughters. Give yourself a clap for believing in Yui Shitmik and all the other seismologists. Give yourself a round of applause. Right? Right? Give yourself a round of applause for believing in Yui Shitmik and them. Right? Who continue to teach the public rubbish. Right? But I am telling you the truth. I am the bad one. As usual. Right? I'm telling you the truth. I'm the bad one. Right? All right. All right, people who believe in you, we should make.
Forever he is faithful. How many can attest to his faithfulness even this week? Hallelujah. My heart is full of gratitude for the faithfulness of the Lord. Prepare the way. Make straight the path for him. Let the King of glory enter in. Let the King of glory enter in.
Alright, so what I'm gonna do here to prove to the public that is the Creator bringing a plague or the Creator showing signs of destruction before he destroy a city, he does show a warning. Right? Yahuwah doesn't destroy a city without a warning. Right, and when you wish it, make and them talk about dice paint, the public sweep it under the carpet one time. They never question, they never go for the self and test it for themselves. I could go there and I could test the water, and I could tell you the water is not paint, right? You could, yeah, let me tell you something, the water not poisonous, no, no, it does red, right? The water does red, that not poison, no, no, the water does blood red, but it's not poison. Right? It's a certain algae, right? It's a certain algae that Yahuwah mix into the water, so on and so on. I can't really give you all the details for that. But in different parts of the earth, people are seeing red, right? Yeah, they're seeing the water turning red. They're seeing the water turning green. They're seeing the water turning blue. And different signs of the triune eternal family. But I'm a madman, so me don't know what I'm saying. But let me just bring up another proof there for you. One of this is the right thing, boy. Right? Now, we see the mud volcano, right? Now, I'm going to bring up for you all. Let's see if I can just get it really quick. Right? I'm going to bring up for you where in the Philippines, let's see if I can find it. In the Philippines, the sky turned blood red. Right? I'm going to bring up that for you as proof. Right? That you wish it making them full of shit. Here we is again. Here we are. I'm going to play the audio. And look for yourself. That is not no green screen. That is real. The place is turning. The sky is turning blood red. The earth, the rivers, the beaches. Everything will begin to turn red just now. Watch. Do you all know I have a prophecy with this red water. Yes, I have prophecy for everything not going on, every event that going on the earth. I have prophecy for every single thing as proof that I said it before it ever happened. So you get the warning before it ever manifests. When it manifests, right, when it manifests, that is your proof, right, that the world is coming to an end. Rather than calling me a madman, check yourself. As we could see right there, it's the same color in the river, it's the same color in the blasted sky, right? So all the river could be paint. They're lying, right? And they keep lying to the public, and the public believe that. But the public don't worry, you know. All they might believe me now, you all might believe me now. But when we cross into the month of August, right, when we cross into the month of August, see this red that you're seeing here is the beginning of destruction, right? The same red appeared in the skies of the Philippines, and after that, Philippines had thousands of earthquakes. You hear? Thousands of earthquakes, and earthquakes still happening right now in the Philippines. You telling me? You telling me that I deceive, but I am the one who more awakened than all of you out there. You see a list of earthquakes, right? We could see a list of earthquakes right now happening in Carupano, right? And no reports from Yui Shitmik and all of them who telling you all, you don't have to worry about nothing, you know, nothing. We're not, you don't have to worry about nothing. Don't worry, everything will be in a gear, everything will be all right. Don't worry, right? So, every time Yahuwah is going to bring a destruction to a particular place, right? Yahuwah releases judgment, he does certain things, right? So, I'm going to show you all another video too, as well. Yeah, another video of the red. Let me see if I can just bring it up there for you. Right? So, look at all the earthquakes happen there, close to Trinidad, and no reports from you we should make, right? But yeah, but all they keep saying things all they don't know about. But here it is. I'm gonna just bring up a teaching here, right? Let me see if I can just open it all, and you will hear some ancient things, and then we will switch back, right? Because I want to make you all understand certain things. I don't know, I can't make you all understand certain things, but I want you all to understand, right, how deceived the world really is. And some ancient thing too as well. Relax, sit back.
So yeah, next question.
Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, Holy One of blessing. You have kept us alive for such a time as...
Yes, indeed, Jeremiah is this destroyed city of Popeli. Actually, Sodom and Gomorrah. No. And now notice your question. No. Popeli is in Italy. Italy is not a part of Sodom and Gomorrah. Italy is a part of the Vatican. Of course, we were all born in heaven as babies, but through a different way. Keep the questions coming. I think we're going a little higher to explaining a lot here. I hope that you're taking notes. So they said that this red sky is fake. And this happened in Philippines a month ago. It happened in Philippines, and it will happen in Saudi Arabia, and soon it will happen in America. But before that does happen, Abba said that he's going to send a sign. And that sign will be 3 blood moons, which one already gone already. So 2 blood moons and a major solar eclipse. Really interesting question, Sister Kim, but I'm here to answer it for you. Amen. Alright, so I'm happy that Kim, that you brought up this question that they brought up about Lucifer. The truth is, there were wool, there were a world or earth that exists before this one. So there were an earth before this earth existed. There were an earth before this earth existed, or there were a world that existed before this world. Nobody on the earth could answer this question because they don't know, right? But I'm explaining it to you. The word Elohim tells me how it went down. So there were an earth before this one. Yes, it was more advanced than the earth that we're actually seeing right now. The earth that existed before is what with it was with Abba parents, all right? Now what I'm saying to you, you never heard it before, and you will never see it nowhere. Sakim, actually I'm still answering that question, but I have to answer it because it is very, very long to explain. So there were a world before this that existed, and it had a God also too. It had a Holy Spirit. It had a world before this. It had a Holy Spirit and it had a Father as well. It were Abba parents. See what I explained to you all here? I think I'm going nuts. Because you will never find this in the Bible. Never. So there were a creator before this world be God. So there are other creators as well, right? But we're not going into that yet. Because what I'm teaching you all here is ancient, hidden things that they will never teach you because they don't know themselves. Unless if they learn it from me, then you know it's the truth. Sorry, Jeremiah, I don't know what was Abba parents' names. That will not be revealed over my lives. Because if I don't know who they were or what their name were or what the name was on the other world that existed, that they destroyed, because they destroyed that world. No, not really, Victoria. I haven't found out that at all. No, they haven't told me that. So the world that existed before, it was far advanced than this one. Because the world that existed before, it existed for a long time. Let me say it existed for a couple hundreds of years, or thousands of years. Remember again, Elohim is a family, right? Just think about the term family. What does the term family mean to you? So there were a world that exists before this. And Lucifer, that way Lucifer came from. Where do you think Lucifer came from? Lucifer came from that other world. So this is why I'm explaining to you all right now. This is the same process that is going to happen with us. We are going to come from this world, going to place into a new kingdom, which is Yahushua's kingdom. And in Yahushua's kingdom, there will be a whole new process, which I'm going to be explaining right down this life. Hey! You all know, wow, these topics is really, really, really beautiful. Love it. So that's where Lucifer came from. Lucifer came from the fallen world, the last world that existed, that Elohim, the Elohim before that destroyed it. So that's another revelation. They were an Elohim before this world begun. And then a new Elohim took the place of the old Elohim, and it becomes a new family. So now you understand, I'm going to explain something else as well. The elders, some of the old elders, is actually Abba and Mama family, or actually Mama and Papa, their family, their mother and father, they are elders in the kingdom. Or they are the ones that in the background, actually still telling Yahuwah what to do on certain circumstances. So that's why it have the elders. The elders is to actually help and direct the creators on certain decisions that they don't want to take upon their own self to do. So the purpose of the elders is to assist the creators in decision making. That's right, Mother Emaya parents were also creators. So you think the Chinese so intelligent? Where think the Chinese came from? The Chinese tribe came from Emaya's tribe. And they are assassins. There are things that people don't know about the creator. But now is the end time, and I have the privilege by Yahuwah to reveal this deep hidden secrets of the kingdom, because this world is coming to an end and a new world is about to begin. So when I use the word a new world, it means a new creator is rising up, where Abba and Mama is going to step down, and Yahushua and his bride, they are going to be the creators. So Yahushua is going to create a new world. A new world Yahushua is going to create. So you understand the pattern, right? I hope you understand what is the pattern. You've got nothing to lose, nothing to lose. Remember when the food was Russian, not knowing where the first meal was coming from. People treated you as if you had no sense. The words of the father were your defense. And now you're living in your mansion. You forget the past, Mr. Big Man, but you should rejoice in his name, your life has changed.
Rejoice in his name, your life has changed.
Be thankful to Jah, he remains. Rejoice in his name, your life has changed.
Rejoice in his name, your life has
That's a wonderful question that you're asking there. If there were a marriage supper before this, yes. So on that old world that existed, they have its souls on that old world for Yahuwah's Animaya's kingdom as well. So that's where we come in. We come in. We existed long. We existed long before this world started. The angels in the flesh. Some of us are ancient angels. Of course, our spiritual self could speak to animals. Yes. Yes, Sister Kim, there will be another world, but it wouldn't be on this earth. It will be somewhere else. Somewhere else. Somewhere else in the universe, Yahushua will create his own creation. So now you know the reason of the 12 tribes, and now you know the reason of the 12 commandments. It was for Israel. It was for people to arise. It was for people to come forth from Abraham generation as well, right? Yes, Abba's marriage was a reunion, as well as the one that we're going to be in soon. Well, it was Jack who carried you through. Yeah. Of course, I'm older in the spirit.
Yes, it's true. How could you forget the Most High? How could you rejoice in His name? Your life has changed.
Rejoice in His name. Your life has changed.
Be thankful to Jack. He remains.
Yes, Sister Wati. Yes, correct.
No. If you're ungrateful, you must go down. You must go down. Just do the will of Jah and you will wear a crown. A clean heart is better than dollars and pounds. Oh, Lord. Rejoice in His name, your life has changed.
Rejoice in His name, your life has changed.
Be thankful to Jah.
Of course, Abba wasn't sacrificed. No, that never happened then. Abba wasn't sacrificed. There wasn't nothing like that in Abba times. No, that didn't happen like that. All right. So in Abba's time, when Abba was a little boy, like his son Yahushua, there was never nothing like sacrifice then. All right. That never come then. So Lucifer fell. All right. That's why Lucifer came from that world, from that evil world. That's where Lucifer came from. That other fallen world that Abba parents destroyed. Lucifer came from that world, all right? And before, you know, it all started with temptation as well. The angels were given free will, all right? Why do we need assassins in heaven? Because Elohim is a family and they are an army. There is an army greater than the armies on the earth. You understand? Do you want to be a part of the armor? Do you want to be a part of the armor of the Most High, or do we want to be we actually want to be actually in the kingdom? There are assassins in the kingdom, all right? Does Abba look like his father? Yes, the same way how Yahushua looked like his father. Yes, Sister Shechem, I was there. I was there from the beginning of the creation. I was there. I think I did talk about that in some last lives that I did on my other profile that I stole. Our real age in the spirit is thousands, not millions. Mr. Sini, nice question. Actually, I don't know what was Abba's song. Never ask. Crying out love. I see some round the streets that a sweet sight becomes their daily. They need some proper education. What I'm actually speaking about, people actually got confirmation. Eh? People who came into Elohim's instant truth, they got confirmation of everything that I'm saying to you all right now. They got confirmations and they saw it for themselves. What I'm saying is indeed the truth. We need to learn the golden children crying out for love. Crying. So it is a blessing right now to be telling you all these ancient things, because the book of Daniel has been opened. And the book of Daniel, the hidden book of Daniel, the hidden scrolls or the seals or the book that was put into secret, it has been revealed to you to the ancient truth of Elohim. So the geyser at Yellowstone is going to erupt for the 10th time, coming soon, very soon. The geyser at Yellowstone is going to erupt for the 10th time. When it reached to the 12th time, you know what time it is. Yes, all foundation stones have meaning. It is written in Revelation 21. All foundation stones have meaning. Shalom to you, Chloe. Yes, some of us is actually connected to the foundation stones spiritually, like amethyst. Like how you are connected to amethyst, Sister Coco. Amethyst is an actual female, eh? And I have proof for that as well. She is a female. Amethyst is a young girl. Amethyst may be about, let me say, is an actual name of a particular being that exists. So all the foundation stones are actual beings. Right, the foundation stones are stones, but there are beings that represent those stones as well. So some of us, when we leave this flesh and go up into the kingdom, some of us will be commanders, some of us will be gatekeepers, cherubims, some of us will be seraphims, some of us will be Yahushua's delight, the way how Yahuwah had his delight with Lucifer singing for him. Well, the thing is, there will be no evil, no unrighteousness, no ungodliness, no homosexuality, none of that ungodliness in Yahushua's kingdom. So they're going to use Lucifer, right through. They're going to use Lucifer, right through, to accomplish their plans. So it means that Lucifer will never die. And Lucifer is working hand in hand with Elohim to get their plans done. If you don't know, the shadow government, Luciferians and them, Lucifer and all the other fallen angels, they do bow down to Yahuwah. They need to
Come down, sir. Let.
And the Lord shall Rastafari sent before one of his words shall pass, this world shall be destroyed. Evil man get lightning and thunder and brimstone.
What division means that you are given particular position in the kingdom, Sister Kim.
And fire, lightning and thunder and brimstone. And who do you want to praise? Jah or Lucifer? Who do you want to praise? Jah or Lucifer?
All right, so I'm going to explain something again here for you to understand. Sometimes you might like green. What's your favorite color? My favorite color is blue. That represents a foundation stones as well. If you have numerous different love for different colors, it means that you all represents those particular colors in the kingdom as well. So if you love a green, if you love wearing green, you love wearing orange, you love a particular purpose, or you love a particular color, well, those colors also represents the kingdom as well. If you actually make the color an idol, then you will lose that position in the kingdom.
Don't let the devil take control. Though I walk through the valley of death, I'll fear no evil one. From the root of David to the vines of King Solomon, Jah reveals himself in flesh, the conquering lion. Evil man get lightning, thunder and brimstone and fire, lightning and thunder and brimstone. And who do you want to praise? Jah or Lucifer? Who do you want to praise? Jah.
So remember to download this live after we are done, so that you know, can always replay it and you can learn more and more and more. You will receive more wisdom and more visions from Elohim. So make sure and download this live afterwards, and every other live, make sure and download it. It's free to download. So the word Satan is to hide Lucifer. The word devil or demon, because the word demon came from the devil. Alright, so the D came from demon, demon came from the devil. So the devil is another word or another characteristics of Lucifer. Lucifer is the devil. Lucifer is Satan.
Don't contradict yourself and talk things that you don't know about. King Selassie's guidance lead us to the divine route. But seek salvation and not destruction. Pray for redemption. In Addison, I'm a Gideon. Prepare for the coming. The subtle things are broken. Evil man get lightning and thunder and brimstone and fire. Lightning and thunder and brimstone. And who do you want to praise? Jah or Lucifer? Who do you want to praise? Jah or Lucifer? Catch up with me tight and don't let go.
This song is about lightning and thunder. I'll send you the link after the live is over.
Let go, don't let the devil take control of your soul. Though I walk through the valley of death, I'll fear no evil one. From the root of David to the vine of King Solomon.
So in the Garden of Eden, what thing happened? What do you think happened in the Garden of Eden?
A man, Jah reveals himself in flesh.
You think it was really a serpent in the garden? Do you think they were really a serpent, a snake in the garden? Or do you think that it means something else? I'm here to explain that to you as well.
Evil man get lightning and thunder and brimstone and fire. Lightning and thunder and brimstone. And who do you want to praise? Jah or Lucifer? Who do you want to praise? Jah or Lucifer? Jah will be tight and don't let go. Don't let go.
Come down, sir. Let.
Alright, so what you understand about Adam and Eve? Let's talk. Nope, it wasn't an actual snake. It's just a word for a bastard. It's just a word for an enemy who moved like a snake.
Up my eyes,
That's right, Jeremiah. Right? Lucifer had sex with Eve. Yes. And conceived Abel. Or Cain and Abel. And Abel. Cain killed Abel. Yes, Sister Angela, we are different angels, different ranks in the kingdom. I lift up my eyes. That's right, Cain was evil as well as his father, Lucifer. I lift up my eyes. I lift up my eyes. I lift up my cry. I lift up my cry. To the hills around Jerusalem, to the God of all the earth. Wow, you all remember. Yes, no angelic name. Yes, Lucifer knew that Eve was already pregnant, but he didn't care. As you can see what's happening right now on the earth, he don't care. Remember that Lucifer is a obstacle being used by Yahuwah. Actually, Lucifer is Abba's puppet. All right, that is truth. Lucifer is Abba puppet, and Lucifer has to do everything that Abba wants him to do. But certain things Abba does not command him to do. He does do it on his own accord, and then according to Elohim's will. If it's Elohim's will, then if the people accept a specific if the people accept a specific thing, Abba does allow it. Sometimes he doesn't allow it at all. Like the New World Order, Abba didn't allow it, but now he allow it, which began on April 15th, 2018. No set was female.
Some people you're right, and then they choose to show you hate.
So some people think that Lucifer is the one controlling things. No. Abba is Abba Yahuwah. Elohim. They are the ones in control of everything. They're controlling the fallen angels, because the fallen angels, they are their puppets. They had to do everything that they want them to do.
From them out of your yard. From them a play bad young. I them a bad fighters.
So yeah, what Eve did? Eve broke the commandments of Elohim. She broke that covenant between she and Adam and slept with Lucifer under temptation, because Lucifer was a more handsome man than Adam. Again, Lucifer was more good looking than Adam. That is why she slept with Lucifer, because Lucifer is a very, very good looking fella.
Oh, pretty girls who Silas, we call them modern day Judas, the spreaders of rumors. Oh, them a bad biters. Hypocritical to Silas, we call them modern day Judas, the spreaders of rumors. Hey, hey, so why should I be afraid of you when you bleed just like I do? The more you try fight, judge your light keeps shining too. So I've got no time for you, cause in my view, you wanna step in on my shoe. You wish you never leave alone and feel so damn confused. How every day you wake, you ache because you.
And next thing people should know, that Adam was created in the image of our father. It means that Adam was black skin and Eve was white skin. Again, Adam was black skin. Adam was created from the dust of the earth, as well as Eve was created from the dust of the earth, but she was created differently from the male.
You fake, and every step you take, I bring you closer to your grave. But I am like a column when I easily shake.
That is why Lucifer is a pimp, because he's a good looking fella. People think that Lucifer have horns and all kind of thing. Nah, Lucifer is a good looking fella.
Guided by the monster defender of.
You see, the horns is to hide who he really is. He's a good looking fella. Lucifer is very handsome.
The fake, yes, ordained to be great. Hold them about fighters. Hypocritical to sideless. We call them modern day Judas. The spreaders of rumors. Hold them about fighters. Hypocritical to sideless. We call them modern day Judas. The spreaders of rumors. But your teeth.
That's right, the rip story is a lie.
Time tongue gonna let you down. Reward for your words shall be profound. How screw all you want, but.
Tell him to your sister Sarah Turbib.
Go do and drown. Me slew you like a liar with a stone from a crown. Not even the dog that they set on the wall of Babylon shall escape in this time. So word to the wise, choose the right side. And down to be hindered by your foolish pride. I said, no weapon formed against I and I shall prosper, prosper. So tell me, so force right and mongered out disrespect and face disaster. Call them a backbiters.
Yes, bro, there were other people then. When Adam and Eve get kicked out of the garden, the generation didn't stop there yet.
Hypocritical to sideless. We call them modern day Judas. Spreaders of rumors. Hold them a backbiters. Hypocritical to sideless. We call them modern day Judas. Spreaders of.
By the way, Lynette is a demon. Lynette is our next name for Jezebel as well. There were no Lynette. I don't know where she come from. Oh God, them fallen angels, they always want to be important, eh? Huh.
But I'm on the nine concoctions, you prove. You can't give me slip when we never see a slip. You can't give me stew, not even cash use. Some must say me power, some must say I'm not refuse. But I can't forget where I talk to the Jews. And what his friends did to the tough gang too. All in the name of suppressing the truth. But I absolute me, them can't pollute. Cause them are backbiters. Hypocritical to sideless. We call them modern day Judas.
Yes, Sister Kim, you should have slapped him in the ugly ass.
Spreaders of rumors. Hold them a backbiters. Hypocritical to sideless. We call them modern day Judas. Spreaders of rumors. Hold them a backbiters. Hypocritical.
Jezebel is Lynette.
Hypocritical to sideless. We call them modern day Judas. Spreaders of rumors. Hold them a backbiters. Hypocritical to sideless. Let's
so now you understand. Please download this live when it's done. Please download this live. No, we didn't even dream to come into that picture. When I say we, you, not me. I was there from since creation time. So since creation time, I was there. I was even there during Sodom and Gomorrah time. I was one of the angels that poured fire upon Gomorrah.
Sometimes I try to make me fall, but I keep feel. Sometimes I really put your mind at stress, but still a blessing.
And that is a lie. No, there were no Lynette, and there will never be a Lynette. They're making up their own story. Wow. They think they can deceive us. They can't deceive none of us. So as long as I'm here, I'm going to teach you all the real truth. Facts. Real facts. So I was one of the angels that was sent in Gomorrah to warn people, to warn them of the impending judgment of Elohim. And they all spit on me. Not only spit on me, but they did all sorts of evil things against me. But there was only one person that actually welcomed me.
Sometimes it's bitter like a gall. Sometimes sweet. No, what eyes don't see.
I'm going to teach you all the foundation.
Someone is humble, down and fall. Rest, I keep my firm upon the feet. It's not everything good feet, good for top. Rear up the shadow of the dark.
So be aware of the shadow of the dark. Who's the shadow of the dark? The Illuminati, the Freemasons, the secret societies that the shadow government invented. They invented the secret societies to hide their identity of who they really are. And they can manifest through these people who sell themselves to them.
See a man raised, but you don't see his heart. Righteousness will preach from the start. So clean up your mind and clean up your thought, yeah.
You can just call me bro. It's all fine with me. The name Elder will be given to me when I enter into the New Yerushalayim. So, one thing Abba said to also teach you all about the elders. So, there are elders who will be entering Yahushua's kingdom as well. So Yahushua will have his own elders, as well as there will be elders in the new Yerushalayim, and there will be elders in Abba and Mama's kingdom. So what's going to happen is when Yahushua marry his bride, Abba Yahuwah and Mama Mother Imaya and Abba Yahuwah, Yahushua and his bride, their kingdom is going to merge together as one. That's the note. That's the reason for the crop circles, so that I can explain it to you. So that's the reason why I actually seen the crop circles all over. It was to explain it to you, so that you will know what the crop circles is really about.
Sometimes it's bitter like a gall. Sometimes sweet. No, what eyes don't see. I don't leave. Someone is humble, down and fall. Rest, I keep my firm upon the feet. From CNN to CBS, if you follow them, you never get the rest. Yes. From TVJ to CBN, the same bad news I play for your head. Same allegation go around the bend.
So the kingdom going to become one.
The black has all to come for dark. It's like the people of us. The people of us. Deserve the joy they can come. What I don't see. I don't leave. Sometimes it's bitter like a gall. Sometimes sweet. I don't leave. Someone is humble, down and fall. Rest, I keep my firm upon my feet. What I don't see. I don't leave. Sometimes it's bitter like a gall. Sometimes sweet. What I don't see. I don't leave. Someone is humble, down and fall. Rest, I keep my firm upon my feet.
Yes, Sister Kim, there will be evil. And the evil that will be there will be Lucifer only. And Lucifer will rise up disciples to follow him. That's like what's happening in this world. All will be tested. So the same pattern that I see happening on this earth is the same pattern that will happen in Yahushua's kingdom. But for 1,000 years, there will be no evil. There will be no evil in Yahushua's new world. There will be no evil for 1,000 years. All right? So after the 1,000 years, what will happen? All right. So just like how Archangel Michael does protect us, was protecting us, we will be the ones protecting Yahushua's new creation.
Can sound of heaven, like the sound of many.
No, evil will never end. It will never end because they're going to use Lucifer as long as possible to test the people's heart.
Waters, it's the sound of worship coming from the throne.
So after the 1,000 years, Lucifer will be let loose again to test the people. It means that Lucifer will actually, the same thing happening on this earth, it's the same thing that will happen. Lucifer will create his own secret society on that world, like the Illuminati, Freemason, and the same thing will happen again. And boom, we will be the ones that have to come to rescue these people again. It's the same thing happening again, and then boom, Yahushua kingdom will come to not to an end, but Yahushua kingdom is everlasting, as well as Elohim's kingdom is everlasting. But when Yahushua's son to come, Yahushua going to have a son as well, and that is where the kingdom is going to continue over and over. So it's a cycle that happens over and over and over again.
There are cries of Adam.
Actually, Sister Wati, there's a lot of women that accompanies Lucifer in the spiritual worm. A lot. The whores, the Jezebels, the prostitutes, the ones that sell themselves, they all sold out. The Jezebels, the ones that all sold out, yes, they are the ones that accompany Lucifer in the spiritual realm, which exists right here in this earth. Because there are different dimensions, means there are different realms, right? There are different dimensions, means there are different realms of creation or different realms of supernatural.
As men from every nation lift their voice to make his glory known. Singing.
Yes, Sister Rosa, those bruises is from the spiritual realm. You know, sometimes you might see a scratch on your arm. It is from the supernatural realm, the spiritual realm, where you are actually fighting right here.
Holy, holy,
by the blood that
God has given, worship you.
And the ram have broken building all day. The residents were occupied. The native
are you
looking. There are 24 elders. 24. Yes, animal. Yes, as well. Animals as well.
Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord. The elders and angels bow. The redeemed worship you now. Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
All right, guys. So something supernatural happened in Uganda, and I'm going to explain that a little bit remaining on this live. So we got all your questions answered. Let me leave some for next day.
But can you hear the sound of heaven, like the sound of many waters? Friends, it's the sound of worship, and it's coming from this throne.
Yes, Abba and Emiah's marriage was arranged before time as well. That's like how Yahushua's wedding is arranged by his parents. Well, Abba's and Mama marriage were arranged by their parents as well.
Holy, holy, holy are you, Lord.
So many things that you fighting battles outside of the dome. No, you're not fighting battles outside of the dome. You're fighting battles right here in this realm, right here in this realm, not outside of the dome. No, you don't get to go outside of the dome. You don't regularly get an opportunity to enter or to go outside the dome. It don't happen like that. Understand? I just get opportunity. Sometimes people might get opportunity to enter into heaven. It's because you are a visitor. All right. You are visiting for a reason. All right. And then they will send you back to your body. So it had to happen on a specific time. Because if the enemy knows when you'll be taken out of your body. All right. Like, let me say astral travel, right? Astral travel. Doing astral travel is very dangerous and deadly. Because if you're doing astral travel and you leave your body, and there is no angel protecting your body, a demon could take over your body and kick you out of your own body, and you cannot enter back into your body unless if an angel come and battle for your body back. Yes, Sister Angela, 12th dimension, 12th supernatural realm. And earth, this realm in the flesh, is also a realm as well. Yes, we do get to choose our wedding garment. Of course I am, Sister Angela. Alright, so what's happening in Uganda? Sister Kim, I think I did explain about that already, but didn't explain about that. Thank you for bringing up that question for me. The battle, right, the Armageddon war will happen when Yahushua is married. So after Yahushua wedding, which is going to happen for quite a long while, not sure how long, but the wedding is going to happen for a while, and after that certain season, Yahushua will return with us. We will return with Yahushua, with our horses, with our sword, and we will destroy the enemies on the earth except Lucifer. So Lucifer wouldn't be destroyed. Before that happens, Lucifer will be thrown into the pit. Before that happened, Lucifer will be thrown into a dungeon, locked up with a seal. So Yahushua will be sealed away. So, as I was saying before, not Yahushua, but Lucifer, all right? Lucifer will be sealed away, all right? Just wanted to explain that to you all. Oh my God, so much things coming. So much things are they bringing into remembrance that it's just snapping, all right? So Lucifer will be cast out into the dungeon, and Lucifer will be sealed into prison for 1,000 years. Yeah. we're gonna go to this right now. Some of the commandments Lucifer did change it around. But when I get the full understanding of the other two commandments, I will make sure to teach you it as well.
I just worship you.
So after this song, we're going to get into this new teaching of what happened in Uganda. I think I did teach about it, but I can't remember what it is now. So I'll have to do a little prayer and fast to get a full understanding. So now you understand, Chloe. I cannot reveal the other two commandments unless if I get full understanding of what it means and what it is, that I can teach you the real truth. I don't do like other people, make up stories and tell you that it will be lying to you and lying against the Creator. No way. Nathaniel fell for different reasons, a lot of different reasons, as Chloe is relating there.
People are staying outside due to the cracks and the landslide which has taken place.
So for now, they are shifting to the district headquarters, but the population is high. There is no accommodation. This is a new district which has no building, which was a sub-county, and we hope maybe the principal of Namisindo Technical will allow them to occupy some classrooms.
Intensified cracks that go deep into the soil with even water now coming out of them. The cracks have broken buildings, causing the residents who are occupying these houses, the natives, looking for refuge.
People are staying outside due to the cracks and the landslide which has taken place.
So for now, they are shifting to the district headquarters, but the population is high. There is no accommodation. This is a new district which has no building, which was a sub-county, and we hope maybe the principal of Namisindo Technical will allow them to occupy some classrooms.
Intensified cracks that go deep into the soil, with even water now coming out of them. The cracks have broken buildings, causing the residents who are occupying these houses, the natives, looking for refuge.
People are staying outside due to the cracks and the landslide which has taken place.
So for now, they are shifting to the district headquarters, but the population is high. There is no accommodation. This is a new district which has no building, which was a sub-county, and we hope maybe the principal of Namisindo Technical will allow them to occupy some classrooms.
Intensified cracks that go deep into the soil, with even water now coming out of them. The cracks have broken buildings, causing the residents who are occupying these houses, the natives, looking for refuge.
People are staying outside due to the cracks and the landslide which has taken place.
So for now, they are shifting to the district headquarters, but the population is high. There is no accommodation. This is a new district which has no buildings, which was a sub-county, and we hope maybe the principal of...
So what happened there?
We'll allow them to occupy some classrooms.
Intensified cracks that go deep into the soil, with even water now coming out of them. The cracks have broken buildings, causing the residents who are occupying...
All right. So what do you think happened there in... that happened in Somalia, right? That happened in Somalia, right? Not Kenya, that happened in Somalia. Today there was an earthquake in Somalia. Shall we look for the earthquake that happened in Somalia today? As proof, let's look for the earthquake that occurred in Somalia today. All right. We look for the earthquake right now that occurred in Somalia. All right. Let's look for the earthquake that happened in Somalia there. There was an earthquake that happened in Somalia there. I wonder if he did report it, boy. 5 hours ago, boy. I didn't see it showing up yet. But there was an earthquake that happened in Somalia. Just looking for it right now. I think I passed it. Right. I think I passed it. I'm not sure if he reported the earthquake that happened in Somalia today. But there was an earthquake that happened in Somalia just today. Yeah. See, boy, where is it? Texas. We'll see if he had it. Should be somewhere here. All right. So the earthquake that happened in Somalia was removed from the app, right? The earthquake that happened in Somalia was removed to the app. As we could see, a 2.3 magnitude earthquake happened in the island, on the island of Hawaii, 5 hours ago, right? 5 hours ago, an earthquake happened on the island of Hawaii. And we know specifically that Hawaii is going to be battered very hard with that hurricane, which is a category 2 right now. So there's a category 2 hurricane called Eric right now heading for the islands of Hawaii. All right. We're looking for that earthquake, boy, that happened. You see it happening. You see, all the small magnitudes of earthquakes that is happening, all the small magnitudes earthquake happening, getting ready for the 10.1 earthquake sometime in the near future. Sometime soon, a few weeks from now, we'll enter into the 10.1 catastrophic earthquake. As I said already, the 10.1 earthquake is the final end, the final edge, the final end, right? The 10.1 earthquake is the end, all right? When the 10.1 earthquake happened, that's the end of that country, the end of that nation, or the end of that people, right? That is the reason why we have 2.7 happening in Oklahoma and all those different places. But when we reach down to a depth of 7,000 feet, then it is registered as a big earthquake because we reached 7,000 feet. 7,000 feet means 7.1, 7.0, 6.9, around 6.8 to 7.0 is 7,000 feet deep. All right? Well, you see 4.2 happening in New Zealand, Gulf of Aden, Aden, all right? You see all these different things happening. You see 2.1 happening in Kingfisher, Oklahoma. Where a big earthquake will happen just now in Oklahoma. A big earthquake soon to happen in Oklahoma, all right? Southern California already had a big earthquake, so we are worrying about there right now. Germany, big earthquake to happen in Germany soon. Panama, Costa Rica border. We nearly reached to the end of cracking Panama, Costa Rica border. We nearly reached to the end of cracking there. All these different places. Dominican Republic is soon to crack wide open. Davao, all these different places, right? But the earthquake that happened in Sunda Strait in Indonesia, had an earthquake 8 hours ago. As you all know, all those places here had earthquake just recently, right? So what happened in Somalia today was a 4.4 earthquake, 4.9 or 4.4 earthquake that happened in Somalia. I'm not seeing it recorded anymore. It's been removed by USGS out of the app. Why? Why are they removing the earthquakes on them, right? But we already have it recorded already, right? We already have it recorded that the earthquake happened about 2 hours ago in Somalia.
The native looking.
All right. So as I was explaining before about the cracks that happening is happening in Uganda as of right now. Let me just pull it down a little bit. Look at those cracks. Wow. So this is what happened in Uganda. Let's just skip it. All right, look at those cracks. All right, so look at these cracks. So the earth crack as well. Remember I told you all, what has happened when Archangel Michael and them doing the crack in the earth. So when he took his sword and he placed it in the earth and he rocket forward, well, the houses that is built within the earth itself, but these houses are built within the earth itself. When the force of the sword was placed in Uganda, and the sword was rocked forward, then this split happened. All right, this split happened. That is the loud boom song that people must be hearing all over the earth. All right. That I've been telling you all, boom, it happens. A prophecy fulfilled.
So I want to make this very, very, very clear and be honest in what I'm saying. Anybody who doubts, anybody have any doubts in their hearts of anything, you will not enter. If there is a little speck of doubt in your heart, you will not enter. Right? If there's doubt, if there's confusion, if there's anything that doesn't match with the righteousness of the creators, you will be left behind. Right? If there's anything that you did against the messenger of Elohim, you will not enter. Right? You will not enter. So I'm making it very, very clear. If there's any doubt in your heart about me, you will not enter into the new Yerushalayim. You will remain left behind and you will suffer what is going to happen, right? But those without doubt in their heart, those who have a clean conscious mind, a clean heart, right? Those that haven't washed their hands in Obia and witchcraft and all these other evil things, they, only those who have not done those things will inherit eternal life. All those with doubts in their hearts, all those with confusion in their heart, plots of ploy, agenda, hidden agendas in your heart, you will not enter. And I'm very serious, you will not enter. At the end of the day, I am the one to say who enters. Yeah, I am the one to say who enters the kingdom of Yahushua. I am the one to say who enters, who not to enter, right? So, play your cards right. You know what I mean? I know you'll understand what I'm saying, right? Make sure, right? Make sure that there's no doubt in your heart. So that when the catching away happens or the rapture happens, that you are not left behind. Because it will be you to catch, not I, not me. So I'll let everybody know one time, even those who are not even in the ark. I'll let you know if there's any doubt in your heart. When that time comes, you will not be raptured. You will not go home. You will not see the kingdom of Yahushua. You will not walk in the kingdom of Yahushua. Right? So, we are on the home stretch right now. And you're not serious. We are on the home stretch right now to enter into Zion.
So the same thing happened in Kenya as well. Look at the crack there. It's a sword that did that. You will only hear that from me. Nobody else knows about this. So right about now, so shout out to all my brothers and sisters. Today is a special life. I want to be explaining about Yahushua and the multitudes. Right? When Yahushua was up on the mountain and they feed the multitudes with two loaves of fish. Sorry, with two loaves of bread and two loaves of fish. It's important that you read what is in the description of this live video, because everything I tell you, it is what it is. It is what the Creator Elohim, it is what they are doing right about now throughout the earth. So this is the life to be on, right, where I will be teaching you some ancient stuff. And I'll be teaching you, what is the purpose of the water spout? What does the water spout do? I'll be teaching you the real truth, or the real fact, and the real history on why, when the Bible claim that Yahushua multiplied the fishes and multiplied the bread. Well, I'm going to explain that to you today. So make sure and invite as much people as possible. Invite as much people as possible. And also make sure to share this live on all groups possible. I really want to help people to understand the deceptions of the fallen angels, which is the Anunnaki, the Enki, the shadow government, the reptilian, and the elites, the evil ones. Shalom to you, Sister Kati, and welcome to you. And Sister Lolita. So if you remember, when I drew, actually drew where the split will happen. If you used to watch my life, or you always watching my life, you will know exactly what I'm talking about. You will know exactly what I'm speaking about. I did a drawing where Elohim teach me, where they showed me over life. If you have enough time, I will be teaching you all that today. Also, I'll be showing you all about Kenya, what caused Kenya to split, and what will be the result of the split. Now, scientists says, you know them as liars. They actually talk about right, and then they choose to show you it. Yes, Sister Lolita, the frogs represents plague. So frogs is actually a plague. If you notice, about 2 weeks ago, there was a plague, a green frogs in India that fall from the sky. They don't know where the frogs come from, but the frogs came from heaven. All right, those frogs will destroy the other frog, the native frogs, and those frogs is going to start to begin to kill people. Run them out of your yard. So there's a plague of green frogs that is happening right now in it's happening in India. From them a play bad young, I them a bad fighters, hypocritical to sideless, we call them modern day Judas, the spreaders of rumors. Oh, them a bad fighters, hypocritical to sideless, we call them modern day Judas, the spreaders of rumors. Hey, so why should I be afraid of you when you bleed your
just like I do. The more you try fight, judge a light keep shining too. So I've got no time for you, cause in my view you wanna step in on my shoe. You wish you never leave a loo and feel so that.
And what are the prophecies? One of my prophecies from 2017 has finally come to pass, where Kenya actually split. Yes, it is in a prophecy.
I'm confused. How every day you wake, you ache because you know you're fake. And every step you take, I bring you closer to your.
So people say it would never happen. It would never happen in their lifetime.
But I am like a column when I easily shake. The certain say I'm feeling on a who can't take. We guided by the monster, defender of the faith. Yes, ordained to be great. Oh, them are bad fighters. People critical.
So all them bad fighters are them are coming for your neck.
We call them modern day Judas. The spreaders of rumors. Hold them about bite.
Soldiers, are you ready for war?
Hypocritical to Silas. We call
salam to you, Chloe Ark.
Them modern day Judas.
And salam to you, Cleo.
The spreaders of rumors. But yet
hey, what's up to you, brothers?
Tongue gonna let you down.
So shout out to all my real brothers and sisters.
Reward for your words shall be profound. How screw all you want, but go loo and drown. Miss loo you like a liar with a stone from.
So right about that, what you need to do is share this life.
Not even the dog that be set on the wall of Babylon shall escape in this time. So where to the wise, choose the right side. And down to be hindered by your foolish pride. I said no weapon formed against I and I shall prosper, prosper. So tell me some course right and more God of disrespect and face disaster. Tell them about fighters, hypocritical too.
And we are live.
Sideless, we call them modern day Judas. Spreaders of rumors, hold them about.
Hey, shout out to your sister.
Fighters, hypocritical.
And to all the real commanders in the house.
Two sideless, we call them modern day Judas. Spreaders of rumors. But I'm on the nine concoctions. You can't give me slip when we never.
So we've seen this other prophecy. That split in Peru.
I see a slew. You can't give me skew, not even cash use. Some say me power, some say I'm not refuse. But I can't forget where I talk to the Jews. And what his friends did to the tough gang too.
So all them backbiters on them.
All in the name of suppressing the truth, but I absolute.
All of them suppressing the ancient truth of Elohim and spreading lies and propaganda against Elohim. And me.
Me them can't pollute, cause them are backbiters. Hypocritical to silence. We call.
So I have a lot to teach you today, right? So make sure you have your pen and your paper.
All them modern day Judas. Spreaders of rumors. Oh, them are back.
So all these spreaders of rumors. You'll be left behind.
It's hypocritical to Silas. We call them modern day Judas. Spreaders of rumors. But them about fighters. Hypocritical to Silas. We call them modern day Judas.
Alright. So we're gonna get to the broadcast, right? I'll run it. I'm gonna run it twice.
Believe it could end up splitting the continent apart. Deborah Pat is tracking developments from Johannesburg, South Africa.
Imagine waking up one morning to find a map.
Believe it could end up splitting the continent apart. Deborah Pat is tracking developments from Johannesburg, South Africa.
Imagine waking up one morning to find a.
Believe it could end up splitting the continent apart. Deborah Pat is tracking developments from Johannesburg, South Africa.
Imagine waking up one morning to find a massive crack running through your home. That's what happened to Elliot Njuguna, forced to dismantle his house by hand before it was lost to the earth below. He lives in Mai Mahiu, part of the Great Rift Valley in Kenya, a region that has already provided a treasure trove of some of the most important archaeological finds in history. And this latest discovery is so significant, scientists predict it will be the fault line along which history is made once again as Africa splits into two continents.
As we are getting ready for the party, right now, so I hope that you all are really enjoying that worship with, brother Julio out there in the Netherlands. All right, so welcome to all my new brothers and sisters, all those that are new. All right, as you can see on the boat and side, as you can see, the earthquakes are happening exactly pinpoint exactly where it is on the map on the right hand side. So exactly where it is on the right hand side, that is exactly where the that is exactly where the earthquakes is currently happening on that side. All right. So welcome to all those that are new. All right. I encourage you to continue to share the live. I encourage you to continue to be on the live. All right. I just want to teach something really fast there. have a lot to do with the tectonic shift. All right. Okay. So you see the earthquakes happening exactly where, you know, where the drawing is. Exactly where the drawing is there. That is actually where it happened there. All right. And that was today. All right. So that was today. All right. That happened. So all those who still want to be stiff neck playing this song for you. All right. If you don't want to wake up and see that I'm actually telling you all the truth and I'm actually telling it all to you, it's up to you to believe.
Naked fool, you think you are cool to deny me for simplicity. Yes, you are gone for so long with your love for vanity. Yes, you are.
Everything that archangels tell you, everything that Archangel Samuel tells you comes to pass. All right. I encourage you right now to leave the psychics, the pastors, the deacons, the false prophets. Leave them behind and come into the ancient truth of Elohim. This is your opportunity to escape the mega tsunami and the major earthquake. This is your opportunity. Neck fools, you know, all those who want to believe in what Devi the psychic saying against me, you could continue to believe in it. All right, she encouraging you to sin. All right. And you know, she encouraging other people to laugh, you know, laugh at the Almighty. You understand? Laugh at the plans of the Almighty. That's what she doing. She provoking the wrath of Elohim upon the Caribbean islands, and so it will come upon them unexpectedly. You understand? They won't see it coming. It will just happen.
You are cool to deny me for simplicity. Yes, you are gone for so long.
Because there will be nowhere to run from the tsunami, nowhere to run from the major tsunami. There will be nowhere to run, Caribbean island people. There will be nowhere to run. This is your opportunity, Trinidadians. Yes. And those from the Caribbean islands that will be listening to us soon.
You have got
hey.
The wrong interpretation. Mixed up with fame, imagination. So take Jessa and Jamoon and Jarrain.
There will be no escape.
Just and forever. Yes, he raised your fantasy, yeah.
People need to begin to listen to me. We're getting closer. We are getting closer to the tsunami. Hello, hello. People need to listen to me. You understand? People need to listen to me. We are getting closer to the mega tsunami. But before the mega tsunami, there must be a major earthquake. Like what happened in Venezuela. Like what happened in Indonesia. Like what happened in Italy. All right? So what happened here? I can't remember all the places that earthquake happened. Hello, all I need to listen to what I'm saying. Hey, what's up to you, Mr. Lalu? All the way in Indonesia, Lombok.
The lips of the righteous.
Yeah, Mr. Lala in Mr. Lalu in Indonesia. The tsunami will be coming from Bali. The tsunami will come from Bali and over to Lombok. All right, so the whole Alhafa Indonesia is going to experience that mega tsunami, that 10.1 tsunami as well. Well, 10.1 earthquake generating a 700 feet tsunami because the earth is a flat earth. Hello, 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 everyone. Because the earth is flat, this is possible. All right, if the earth wasn't flat, it would have been impossible to bring forth a tsunami because Abba would have had to curve the water and all kind of thing. But the earth is a flat earth, hence the reason why a tsunami is very easy to go across nations.
Hey, but food died for want of wisdom.
On the lies of Babylon, they're lying to you. I'm telling you that the earth is a spinning ball. They lie. They lie. It is not impossible for a tsunami to hit the Caribbean island because the whole earth is flat.
Yes, he raised your fantasy. Destruction of the poor.
So think about it. It's not impossible for a major or a mega tsunami to happen because the earth is flat.
Destruction of the soul is vanity, yeah. So stiff naked fools, you think you are good.
I know, I'm not in any flat earth society or any sort of that organization of the Illuminati. Understand? I teach you righteousness and other people spread it. And then they change the wrong approach in their own words too as well, eh?
Just deny me for simplicity. Yeah, yes, you are gone.
So do you see the earthquakes are happening exactly where the alphabet is? And the reason why I put it in an alphabetical order, so that people in different countries who cannot speak English, they will understand the alphabet. Although it might be in a different dialect, they can understand the alphabet. So wherever the alphabet, wherever the earthquake hits, that is exactly where the alphabet will be. Because this is the alphabetical order of the triune eternal family. So instead of explaining things more in depth, or putting things in depth that you all will understand spiritually, you know, I'm talking about something really, really high, something that you will understand, something that nobody knows about. I just put it in an alphabetical order, so it will be very easy to detect.
Don't
we're looking at the letter A. Lord, look where the letter A is. Let's look where the letter A is on the right hand side, and you will see where the earthquake happened today. All right. And let me even go back to another day, and you will see the earthquake happening. You will see the earthquakes in Trinidad happening, the exact spot where all the alphabetical is in order. All the where all the alphabets is, where all the numbers is, you will see the earthquakes happening, the exact spot. Today's teachings of the tectonic plates. I just wanted to teach you something else again, so let's just go to that. I just waiting to see if we have more people on the live. Come on, start to share the live, invite more people to the live. Join. I'll show you exact spot where the earthquake is happening. Exact spot. So I'm going to bring up another drawing that I did where the earthquake is happening. The exact spots where it's supposed to. They said that nobody could predict earthquakes, but that is a lie. Only I could predict earthquakes on the earth, of course, right? Accurately. Tsunami will be coming from, yes, between Panama City and Kawaku. And when the tsunami meets up with Trinidad, tsunami is going to generate the 700 feet. So that's how it will generate the 700 feet, right? So coming down the Caribbean islands, it will be like 500 feet on the different side of the Caribbean island. It will already be 700 feet because the way how the tectonic plates is right now aligned in a triangle sort of format in order for the water to rise and drop. All right, so I will be showing you that in just a sec. All right, I did a full drawing of the earth, so you know I'll be showing you all about that in a sec. Please invite some more people to listen to the live though. Such a natural mystery, blowing through the air.
Oh, what a rat race, yeah. Oh, what a rat race. This is the rat race, yeah. Rat race, rat race. Summer love, summer, summer boss, summer, summer jack, summer. Oh, what a rat race, yeah. Rat race. Summer boss, summer. In this year, rat race, yeah. Rat race, I'm singing that when the cat's away, the mice will play. Political curiosity.
We're going to be going on the UE, I'm going to go on the UE seismic place, page, and I'm going to show you how these people are really stupid, all right? Because they say nobody could predict, nobody cannot predict earthquakes. They make some point in there. All right, so they don't want you to think that I could, they don't want you to, they don't want you to know that I am the only one who could actually predict earthquakes accurately on the earth. All right, they want to be the source that you come to so that you will continue to be deceived. You know, I'm gonna go on their page. Let's see if I can find it really quick.
Rasta don't work for no CIA. Rat race. Rat race, rat race, rat race. I'm saying, when you think it's peace and safety, a sudden destruction.
I'm gonna go on their page now. Collective safety. I'm block me in the UE.
Don't forget your history. Know your destiny in the abundance of water. The food is thirsty. Rat race. Rat race, rat race, rat race.
What a disgrace.
The
I just heard Abba said, hello to everyone again who's newly joining. Abba Yahuwah said that the earthquake is going to happen in the night. Again, Abba said the earthquake is going to happen in the night, just like what happened to Venezuela. All right, the earthquake for Trinidad, the 8.5, all right, it's going to happen, you know, like in the afternoon time around, let's say 5:23 p.m. around that time. You can look to my page, I already have it there. But the 10.1 earthquake is going to happen during the night. That is going to be very, very terrifying, trust me. I can be, you know. All right, so we're going to get back right now to the US size, man. All right, so we're going to look exactly where the earthquakes are happening. You judge for yourself, all right? And you can see, you know, that this is Bridgetown here. Around here, Bridgetown. You see Kingston. You see St. George, all right? See Barbados up the right, and if you can look on the map, if you're looking on the map, you can see for yourself where all the earthquakes is happening, exactly where, you know, exactly where this is here. But let me bring up a different drawing. So as you can see there, that is a different drawing right there for you there. That's a complete different drawing. All right, you can see exactly where the earthquakes will be happening. It should pop up there soon to you. Alright, so let me just get things in and get it. So as you can see there, I bring up the drawing. I hope my mouse begin to show up there. I just want to show you all exactly where the earthquakes is happening right now. As you can see, this is Kingston, right? Kingston is in Jamaica, right? Let me look where Kingston is. Look Kingston here, right? Let me look west by the earthquake. This earthquake on the right hand side. On the left hand side. See Kingston, see Kingston underneath here, right? Look Kingston right here, and look at the epicenter. You see it? Look Kingston here. Let me just bring up this people. Look Kingston here, alright? This is we're just bringing it back to me. This is Kingston. And you can see here, you can see Kingston here too as well, right? See Kingston here, see the epicenter. The earthquake happened exactly where my drawing is. So as you can see, exactly where the drawing is. Look where the drawing is. Alright, just look where the drawing is. This is the drawing here on the right hand side of your screen. And you can see my mouse just going over, hovering over Kingston. And right under Kingston, there's an epicenter. There's E. Alright, there's a letter E. That is where earthquake happened. Alright? Alright, so as you can see, the epicenter here. See the epicenter right here. This is the epicenter. And you can see Kingston, Jamaica right here. All right, right there. And on the other side of the map now, you could see, here where the earthquake happened. This is the epicenter, so this ought to be E, right? So this ought to be E. All right, so this ought to be E. So these are places always seen in the alphabet, and the places that you don't see anything, that is an extension of the tectonic plate. And I think I did an explanation about it. All right, let me go elsewhere now. All right, let me go here now. All right, so you're seeing there, right? And if you look on this side, you're seeing, let's look where Rusiro is. Look where it is, exactly where my drawing is, right? And they say that nobody could predict earthquakes. That is a lie, folks. And I did this drawing way before the earthquakes happened, by the way. So way before the earthquakes happened is when I did the drawing. So this is not something I, you know, just did. I did that since the November month. Alright? Exactly where the drawing is, exactly where the everything is, that is exactly where all the earthquakes is happening. Exactly where it's supposed to happen. Because what is on the map, what is drawn in the map alphabetically, it is happening the exact spots. So when they talk about earthquakes, nobody can predict earthquakes, that is a lie. At least them can predict earthquakes, because they know they don't know Yahuwah. You know, if you know Yahuwah, you know, if you know Yahuwah, only then you can predict earthquakes. You know what I mean? You can't, you know, you really have no power to predict earthquakes without Elohim, eh? You know, you have no power at all to predict earthquakes without Elohim. So you need Elohim to, you know, to predict earthquakes. Because Elohim will teach you the exact spots of the earthquake, exactly where it will happen, and exactly where to look out for it at the same time. Alright, so let me look at a different place. All those places is where earthquakes happen, alright? So this is so this is stating that this is on the Indonesian plate. So this is on the a little above the New Zealand plate. All right. I didn't put any alphabet there because that doesn't include the Caribbean islands, but it have a connection to the Caribbean islands. So this is the New Zealand plate here. Alright, so this is the New Zealand Indonesia plate. It's about here, so about here, about right here will be the Indonesian plate, right? About here, so about here will be the Indonesian plate, but this is the New Zealand plate. All right, so let me just scroll down. No, I'm showing all the facts. I'm showing all the facts. Everything that I've been saying coming to pass. All right, look where France is. Let me look where Port of France is. Look where Port of France is. All right, look where the earthquake happened. It happened on the exact E. All right, just look where it is. All right, just look where Port of France is, and just look above. Alright, the earthquake has happened within all my drawings. Every alphabet is where the earthquakes are happening, and some hasn't happened certain places yet, but it will happen soon. Alright, so let's go into our next one now. Where's St. Kitts and Nevis? Alright? I think St. Kitts and Nevis might be somewhere around here, but this is on our different drawing. This is on the different drawing, alright? Alright, so the earthquake's happening in the exact spots that I tell you what happened. St. Kitts and Nevis is on the first map I just showed you just now there. Alright? So on the map I just showed you, that is where St. Kitts and Nevis will be shown and where the epicenters and stuff like that will be. Alright, so back to Trinidad now. Now I don't have up a Trinidad map, right? So that means I had to swap it. Alright, so as we can see, where the earthquake happened is on. Let's see where this is happening. The earthquake happened B. Just look where the island is on the map, and just look where it is on their. Look where on their map. That is where they detect it, and that is where I already have it. I already have it there. So all the alphabet there is active. Alright, except K and L inactive yet, but shouldn't be active. H already active. N not active quite yet, but I've been working on activating N here. C is already midway being activated, and B is a major a major tectonic plate, by the way, right? B and A is two major points of the Maturin tectonic plate now, you know. Alright, so this is how I could predict earthquakes. This is how I predict earthquakes accurately, 1 million, billion, zillion, zillion percent. Because the fact that Yahuwah speaks to me and tell me exactly where exactly he's going to shift. Where exactly he's going to register as an earthquake. So Yahuwah, the creator, he tells me exactly where he's going to cause earthquakes to happen. So the exact points, there's also a teaching about it, a full teaching about it. So nobody can say I just make up this or I just joined this. This is a full 4 hours teaching. Alright, 4 hours teaching straight of everything that you want to know about the tectonic plate. Everything that you might want to learn. Yeah, you can learn that there. So we scroll down. Alright guys, so where do you pick up in here? Let me look where G is. Look where G is. Come on. Go ahead. Look where G is, folks. Look where G is. Alright. Look where the earthquake happening on the map. Alright. Look where it happening here. This is on the UE seismic page. Yeah. Alright. Look here. And look, my, you know, look, Elohim was on here. It happened exact spot. Again, look where G is. Look where the earthquake happening here. So look where it happening exactly. On their map, their version of the map is the same thing. That's my map, just a little bigger, and you know, but it's the same place. Look where the G is, and look where this is. It's the same place, folks. It's the same place. It's the same place. You understand? Maturin is not far at all. This is where the mega earthquake is going to happen. This is where the major earthquake is going to happen here. Major here. All right. So the major earthquake will happen here, and the mega earthquake will happen here. All right. Mega earthquake happened Maturin. Major earthquake happens Capano. All right. Capano is where the major earthquake will occur, and the mega earthquake will happen Maturin. And when this happened now, yeah, from Paul Lama straight across will be split. All right. And then the tsunami will be generated around, let's see where the tsunami will be generated. The tsunami will be generated from up here, and there will be a tsunami to generate right here too as well. Cause look where the land is. All right. It look like if it do have a large mass of water, but around here, folks, it's very, very deep. All right. So what will happen is ABBA will pull the water from here. So the water from all here, right? I hope you seen my mouse. The water from all here will be pulled up into the central tectonic plate. So the water will be pulled up, all right, and it will be pulled up in the central tectonic plate. Then when the 10.1 earthquake happened, Panama City, all right, then it will meet up with the central tectonic plate, and that is what will cause the 700 feet. Again, the 10.1 earthquake will occur between Panama City and Karaku. That will generate a mega tsunami about 500 feet, all right, or more. All right, and when it meets up and it's coming down to the Caribbean islands, when it reaches Caparo, all right, it will stop because there will be a bridge here. All right, there will be a bridge here to pool the water, or sort of like a dam. Build a dam right here, so a dam will be built. All right, a dam will be built here, and when that dam is built, all right, then he will release the water on Trinidad. The water will be released from the central tectonic plate. All right, so yeah, that's giving you a better understanding of how the tsunami going to happen for Trinidad. And when the 500 meets up with the 200 feet that will be happening here, so the 200 feet will be happening here, 500 feet coming up here. When it reach here, it sorts a pool like we've seen in the drawing here. It will sort a pool right here on the alphabet, and it will build a sorta like a gate. So behind F and G will be the water will be pulling up there. The 500 feet water will be pulling up between the E and the G. And then when the water reached up to a certain maximum, it's going to be released onto Trinidad. That is how the tsunami is going to happen, folks, because the because the fact that the 500 feet coming in, the 500 feet will clear this piece of island here. So this piece of island here, Capario, all right, Capario will be removed by the 8.5 earthquake. All right, so the 8.5 earthquake will remove Capario. All right, I wonder if I'm making sense. The 8.5 earthquake will Capario will remove this piece of island here will be removed in order for the 500 feet to come here. You understand? But the earthquake will happen Maturin. Let me see what I find it. The earthquake will happen Maturin and stretch all across to Capario. Alright, so it will build a sort of trench here. So a trench will build here, and this will be like a new, how to say, this will be like a new path for the tsunami now to grow even higher, to go to Venezuela. So after the tsunami affects Trinidad, wipe out half of Trinidad, because half of Trinidad will be around here soon. When the tsunami happens and wipe out half of Trinidad, it will be leaving from up here, and now it will be going down to Maturin. It will leave, well, your mama tell you, there will be a trench from Maturin to Capriol, right? That means that the tsunami will be coming all down here. The water from here will already be, you know, going down this channel, all right? And then taking up, whatever making sense, then the when it reaches a certain point or a certain island, it will grow again in a more, you know, it will grow like, let me say, it will go to 700 feet again. It will actually drop because it reached certain places. It will drop and then it will build again. It will drop and then it will build again until the Caribbean islands is wiped out. So that's the reason why for the small earthquakes. That's the reason why the small earthquakes is occurring, all right, in certain places around the earth, because of the tsunamis, the 7 mega tsunamis that is going to happen around the earth. Music is the voice of his brother Aaron, yes. Preaching and comforting as the fathers command. Music is the rod and we are Moses. Oh, he's there, leading God's children to the promised land. Music is the voice of his brother Aaron, yes. And as you can see, the earthquake happened the exact day again, alright? I don't want to stick too long on this, but I just wanted to show you all the earthquake happening exact spot. Exactly where the B is. Exactly where the B is. Look where the B is up here. Look where my fire, look where my mouse is. Exact up here where the B is. That's exactly where the earthquake is happening here on their map. So it happened in the exact spot where my drawing is, right? Music is the rod and we are Moses, yeah. Leading God's children to the promised land. Music is the voice of his brother Aaron, yes. Preaching and comforting at the Father's command. We have the power to turn things around. So look where my drawing is, right? Let's look where my drawing is. Look where they have a collage of where earthquakes is happening here on different timing, right? So you can see here, let me see if I have that. You see, I have all the alphabets. Look. All the alphabets here is activated. As you can see. Music is the voice of his brother Aaron, yes. Preaching and comforting at the Father's command. No use in trying to compromise the truth. Alright, so look where earthquakes is happening, and let's look where my drawing is. And if you look at my drawing, you see where all the alphabet letters is. Is where all the earthquakes happen accurately. Alright. Alright, so we'll be going into the major teaching. I'm gonna just put it up there for you. Any questions, please, any question, please ask. Any question you have, you are free to ask. Whatever question you have, free to ask, all right? Free to ask your questions. Any questions, please ask, all right? We're going to get into teachings. Music is the rod and we are Moses. Oh, yeah. Leading God's children to the promised land. Music is the voice of his brother Aaron. Preaching and comforting at the Father's command. We have the power to turn things around. We have to stand up when we fall to the ground. I see this little sun. Alright, so we're gonna, since there will be no relevant other questions, we will look to get into the live, you know, look to get into the major teaching today of the tectonic plates, alright? Yeah, LNK is actually really active because L and A will split. K and L will do splits. Always see where the splits are. Those are not yet active places where earthquakes is not happening there yet. But in a few days from now, we should be getting earthquakes where K and L is, where M and N is. We should be getting earthquakes there in a few days from now.
Elohim, Most High, in the name of Yahushua, HaMashiach, the one who was and is, who is and is to come, I come to worship and magnify your name. Come to worship and magnify your name.
All who don't think that I'm actually predicting earthquakes accurately, they are fools. Seriously, right?
I've come to magnify your name.
All those who continue to doubt, mock, and scoff is up to you, all right? No, I am not mad. You are the one who mad, doubting everything that Archangel Samuel says. You are the one who is mad. You are the one that needs a mental checkup, you know?
By your name.
Shalom to everyone. Good night, good morning, good afternoon to everyone. Today's live is going to be very, very special. As you can see, you can start asking questions. Who is that old man with that white beard, that dark man? You can start asking your questions now.
Magnify your name.
As you can hear the name Yahuwah, Yahuwah, Yahuwah. So let's get some shares for this live. So share the live, and let's get some more people on the live, because this live is going to be mind-blowing. I'm going to be teaching you in depth, in real in depth, how the foundations of the earth was started, how it was created from scratch to how it is right now.
Elohim, Most High, in the name of Yahweh.
Yahushua HaMashiach, the one who was and is, who is.
So the colors represent the foundation stones of the kingdom of Yahushua. All right. The colors again represent the 12 new Yerushalayim stones, or the 12 foundation stones of the new Jerusalem.
And is to come, I've come to worship and magnify your name. I've come to worship and magnify.
Right, so that old man that you're seeing there is our father. That is his true way he looks. All right, I had to look for some pictures. I will be looking for some pictures of Yahuwah up close and personal. I think I did a live recently about Abba. I just have to remember which folder I have it in right now. So I'll be teaching you real in depth. All right, real in depth. So I'll be showing you, I'll just giving you a look at what we're going to be teaching today, or what I'm going to be talking about today is going to be real important. It's going to be real interesting. So you need to share this live on all the groups, share this live on all the groups that you can think about. All right, please share this live and let us get people learning the ancient truth of Elohim before the 1st of November. All right, we're going to enter into a catastrophic earthquake or magnetic zone of earthquakes that is going to be happening throughout the Caribbean as well as throughout the earth. Okay, today there was a 5.5 earthquake that hit Manama, and I'll be showing you the video from Manama of the earthquake that happened today in Manama, all right?
Hello. In the name of Yahushua HaMashiach, the one who lived and died and rose to live again.
Shalom to you, Commander Azar. Shalom, shalom to my Philippine family as well. Shalom. Hey, shalom to you, Brother Romy. What's up to you, bro?
I've come to magnify your name.
So let me just give you a sneak peek. Let me just give you a sneak peek of what I'm going to teach you today. Let me see if I can find it really quick. All right, I'm going to show you a little sneak peek of what I'm going to teach you really quick. This, see this right here? This will be the foundation, the clock, and everything. I'm going to be teaching you really in depth, real in depth of the everything that made up the foundation of the earth. I'm going to teach you in depth. I'm going to scrap this and show you from scratch, so to speak, how Yahuwah start everything from scratch, how we created the dome. I'm going to be teaching you real in depth of the earth, where earthquakes going to happen next, where it's going to be, where it's going to split next, where magnitude of earthquake going to happen. All right, so I'm going to be teaching you real things. I'm going to be teaching you of everything. So this here is the wrong, all right, it's the clock, all right, and I'll be teaching you when Yahuwah speak about the when he spoke about the 12th hour, all right, or the midnight hour, what he means. So I'll be showing you all that in a sec, all right. In a sec I will be teaching you all that as well.